Hey, this is Paul from Wondershare MobileTrans, and today what we want to do is show you a video where if you want to swap your apps from your old iPad over to your new iPad, then we will show you just how. In fact, let's show you three different methods to help you move those apps from your older iPad over to your brand new iPad. Luckily for you, you've come across this video if you're looking to move those apps over to an iPad, and we will show you those three methods. And of course, they are really simple and nice and easy, so we can get those apps moved from your old iPad to your new iPad in no time at all. Our first method is to use iTunes, which kind of means that this is more for some Windows users. And with iTunes, it means it can help move all of your apps, all of your data over from the iPad to your new iPad in just a couple of clicks, and it shouldn't take long at all. This means photos, music, documents, all of that will move over. So let me show you the really easy methods that you can use to move that data from your old iPad to the new one. The first thing you should do is connect your iPad to the computer with a good working USB cable. Next, open up iTunes and just make sure that you're running the latest version of iTunes, because sometimes if you're not running this latest version, it can cause a few problems with the next steps that will be in this video. Then what you'll need to do is make sure you make a backup by clicking that Backup Now button. And if this iPad has a lot of data on it, then it could take a little bit of time to back it up, because it will be backing up everything that is on that iPad. So all documents, all photos, all videos, everything. But then once it's finished, just disconnect the iPad from the computer. Once you've done that, you then need to go and get your new iPad and connect that to the computer and click Restore Backup. Then the option should be there for you to pick that latest backup, which would be the one that you have just backed up. You then click Restore to begin the process, and just make sure you keep the iPad connected until it's all done. And of course, that might take a bit of time depending on how much data you have to move over. However, it is important to note that only the apps that you have purchased using your Apple account and your Apple ID can be transferred in this way. Okay, now we've shown you that first method, we are on to method number two, and this actually is quite similar to that first method, but this method is to use iCloud to transfer your data and your apps from your older iPad over to your brand new one. And like I've said about all these methods, they are all nice, quick, and easy to do, and this one is no different. So let me show you how you can use iCloud to move over those apps to your brand new iPad. The first part is to make sure you take a backup. So head into Settings on the iPad and find your Apple ID. And then make sure that iCloud backup is turned on. You'll of course then need to be connected to Wi-Fi for this backup to happen. And once it's on, it should start taking that backup right away. And sometimes it can take a bit of time. So again, just sit back and wait. When your backup is actually complete, you can then start to set up the new iPad. And when you get to the apps and data screen, you need to make sure that you select that Restore from iCloud backup. At this point, you then just need to enter your Apple ID and password and just do everything that it asks you in the setup, and then just follow all the steps and your iPad will take its time to download all of these apps. But if you give it that time, then all those apps, all that data, including photos, documents, messages, will all be moved from that old iPad to your new one. But remember, it can take a bit of time, so just be a little bit patient. Now we're on to method three, and this method is a little bit different, but this means that you can move over absolutely everything from your old iPad to your new one. So that is messages, data, it's photos, it's videos, it's everything that was on your old iPad. You can move it over to the new one with some nice easy clicks, and that is to use a piece of software called MobileTrans. This software can move over absolutely every bit of data from your iPad except moving over those apps. So here we go. Let's show you those ways to move over absolutely all of your data using mobile trans. And remember, you don't need to be technical to do this. You just have to follow these next steps. You need to make sure you download the software first, and you can do that by clicking the description below and just follow the link to the official website. Once you've downloaded, you then open it up, and on that main screen, you need to click on phone transfer. Even though this says phone transfer, this will help you move over your iPad data. Don't worry about that. You'll need to connect both devices to the computer and make sure you are using a good working USB cable, and then MobileTrans will detect both devices. It will show a picture of an iPhone, but trust me, these are the iPads that are connected. Make sure that the old iPad is the source device, and then make sure that the new one is set to the destination device. And you can also flip it with the button up at the top. You'll see in the middle part of the screen all the data that you can move over from the old iPad to the new one. So select all the data that you want to move over, and then just like that, all you have to do is select start. You can also remove data on the new device as well if you've set it up before, and you do that by just clicking that small box at the bottom. Just keep the devices connected until the process is finished, and then all the data that you selected to move over will have moved over to that brand new iPad. There we go. Some methods there to help you move over your apps from one old iPad to a new iPad. So if you followed those steps, those apps should have all transferred over. And then, of course, MobileTrans showed you how to move all of your data to that new iPad, and it gives you a really nice, easy, quick way to do it, and doesn't take any knowledge of these things at all because the steps are so easy to follow. Let us know in the comments if you want any help with some similar problems, and then hopefully we can get back to you. If you enjoyed the video and it helped you out, why not give it a like, and of course, subscribe to the MobileTrans channel. And if you do all of that, I will see you in the next video.